Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the alkylation of alkynes. So we're going to start with maybe a simple alkyne here. We'll just start with acetylene. This is the common name, also called ethyne. And we're going to make a carbon-carbon bond. So alkylation means that we're introducing an alkyl group, which is a carbon group. If you're taking organic chemistry in the traditional sequence, this is your first opportunity to make a carbon-carbon bond. So that can be a useful thing to think about when you're doing a complex synthesis problem. This is the one way you'll know how to do this. So we're going to take advantage of the mildly acidic nature of the acetylenic CH, so that being the H coming off of a carbon-carbon triple bond, by introducing a strong base that can deprotonate it, and then we'll introduce a carbon chain with a leaving group on it. So I'm going to label our carbons so we can keep track of them in the product. And we will draw the product, then we'll get going with the mechanism. So it's going to remove one of my CH bonds and then replace it with a carbon-carbon bond. So I will draw a squiggle through the carbon-carbon bond we made right there. And then I'm going to number again so that we can tell what our carbon chain, how it was that it connected. So the first step is deprotonation. So we're going to start with our acetylene here and introduce our strong base, because acetylene is a pretty weak acid. We're going to use the amide ion. This is a small atom with a localized charge, so it's going to be a pretty strong base. It's not very electronegative in nitrogen, just a little bit. And so it's going to be strong enough to sufficiently deprotonate this molecule for the reaction to occur. So this is just an acid-base reaction right here. And this will generate, in this particular case, acetylide. IDE tells me I've got a negative charge, and then ammonia as my conjugate acid of my strong base. So I made acetylide here. It is a base. It's also going to be the nucleophile in this reaction. So we're actually going to proceed through an SN2 reaction in the next step. Okay, so I've redrawn our reaction scheme just for a reference point. In the first step, we had deprotonated the triple bond, making acetylide, which is a strong base but also a really good nucleophile. And so if we use an unhindered system, like a methyl or a primary alkyl halide, we can see an SN2 substitution reaction. So I'm going to draw our alkyl halide down here. When I see this 1, 2 by my reagents, and you could have a 3, 4 as well, right? Any number of steps could be needed for a reaction. This just tells you that you're introducing the reagents one at a time. So if you put them together, often they can react with one another. So we first accomplish the deprotonation of our triple bond to give us our nucleophile here. And then in a second step, when that is finished, we would introduce, in this case, an alkyl halide. If I introduce an unhindered alkyl halide, then I can see an SN2 reaction like this. So I'm going to number my carbons again. But this is just a backside attack. You have a nucleophile come in as the leaving group leaves. It's a primary system, and so it would avoid a carbocation, which would be unstable on a primary carbon. And this would give me my final product with a new carbon-carbon bond. And so instead of having a terminal H anymore, that carbon chain is going to now be attached to a new carbon group, and there's my squiggle for that bond that I've made right there. So this reaction will work well if you have a methyl or a primary alkyl halide. So really just like an unhindered system there. You'll see a substitution reaction, specifically via SN2. But the issue here is that the acetylide that we make is a good nucleophile, but it's also a strong base. And so as our system gets more hindered, we're more likely to see an elimination reaction. So if you use a secondary or a tertiary alkyl halide, instead of seeing substitution reactions, you're going to see elimination reactions, and specifically E2 elimination. So let's just say that I have this acetylide ion, and I'm hoping to do a substitution reaction, but my starting material looks like this. This is a secondary carbon, and it's more hindered. And so instead of behaving as a nucleophile and going all the way into that electrophilic carbon that's labeled secondary, it can pluck a proton off of the edge of the molecule, and that is a lower energy pathway. And so instead, we would see an elimination reaction to form an alkene. So that would give me just this alkene here, and then I just regenerate my alkyne that I started with, because instead of acting as a nucleophile, it acted as a base and it plucked off a proton. So this is a very useful reaction for forming a carbon-carbon bond, a new carbon-carbon bond, but it only works with unhindered systems. Okay, so you can only see substitution on a methyl or a primary alkyl halide. If it's secondary or tertiary, it's going to go through an elimination reaction. This has been a look at the alkylation of alkynes. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.